Incorporated. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Jonathan Mason.
As I stand here today, I represent Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated. A fraternity founded on the campus of Howard University on January 9, 1914. A proud brotherhood of more than 150,000 men. The fraternal home of Asa Philip Randolph, George Washington Carver, President William Jefferson Clinton, and yes, the man of the hour, Congressman John Lewis. Congressman Lewis, I'm reminded of the story that you often share. As a young boy of six growing up on a farm in the rural South, you look past the dogs, you look past the hogs, you sidestop the cows, and you gave your full attention to the animals that were the least of these, the ones on the lowest rung of the barnyard ladder. Yes, Congressman Lewis, you gave all of your attention to the chickens. You shared with us how you witnessed to the chickens, how you preached to the chickens, and if they felt the spirit, you even baptized some chickens. Well, Brother Congressman, your fraternity and your country, thank you for always standing up for the least of these. We thank you for standing up during the Freedom Rides. We thank you for standing on the Edmund Pettus Bridge. We thank you for standing in Congress over decades defending the rights of the least of these to have a seat at the table of success. Yes, Congressman Lewis, you were standing for all of us. But what we really know is that you were standing on the promises of God. And through it all, I believe the words of David stayed on your mind, where he said, I was young and now I'm old, and I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. Congressman Lewis, it's time for me to take my leave. But I want you to know that your fraternity loves you. And we have invested and will continue to invest in the documentary project that will tell the story of the life of Congressman John Lewis. You see, generations to follow must know that there was a man named John Lewis that dared to stand and dared to get in good trouble so that all of God's children could live free. God bless you, Congressman Lewis, and may the Lord